This rubber fly is a remarkable insect. You could call it the top gun of the fly world. It can spot, track, and kill his prey in half a second. That is equivalent of a human spotting and catching his prey at the other end of a football pitch. So how does it do this? My name is Paloma González Bellido, and we have been studying this incredible insect using high-speed video cameras and microscopic images. We found that the rubber fly has very sophisticated eyes. The majority of insects have compound eyes, but this means is that they have one lens per each sensor on each unit. You can imagine that if you want a high-resolution eye, you will have to have a really big eye because there are so many lenses. And so we actually wonder, how is it that this small animal can actually do this task while being so small? What we discover is that it had, of the many lenses in this eye, many of them were small, but some of them were really, really large. And these large lenses were actually at the center of the eye. Beneath it, there are actually very, very small sensors. And what this means is that this fly gets a really high resolution image of the wall just in that small part of the field of view. When it spots its prey, the fly launches itself upwards, maintaining the same relative angle to his prey while moving closer and closer. This means that the rubber fly can maneuver himself mid-air if his prey changes direction. Once the fly is within 29 centimeters of his prey, although we don't know how it measures this distance, the fly locks onto his prey while changing its own trajectory. It then sweeps around, slows down, and comes alongside his prey to make his final attack. We think this is an amazing insect that could help us develop better robots or drones. Nowadays, one of the problems with drones is that they basically consume a lot of energy and they will drain their batteries very, very quickly. This is because it takes energy to process all the visual information so that they can actually navigate the world without crashing. As is often the case, we can take lessons from the natural world to minimize these power requirements. This, combined with a remarkable rubber fly hunting ability, can help us better design drones. So, for example, these drones could be used in rescue operations where it is not safe to send a human into a house that has been on fire, for example. But more specifically, the ones that we're working with at the moment, or the idea at the moment, will be that this will be useful for drones to take down other drones that are illegal, say, for example, in a concert or in an airport.